You remember those pinpoint impression things? You know, you put your hand on it, you put it on something, you put it on your face. That's Zordon! What's happening, my film friends? David the Film Junkie here, bringing you a film review of Power Rangers. Power Rangers, of course, is based on the old TV show, which apparently was old, like, Japanese, like, a show that, you know, with them and the Power Rangers and fighting the people. And they kind of spliced in like this whole other story with actual actors. And they did this whole, like, every time they talked, they had to do this. So it's a reimagining, okay? Because, you know what? I'm not going to lie. I watched the show, the original. As soon as it started getting into, like, Power Rangers Turbo or Ninja or Geisha or whatever the hell it turned into, I stopped. So we see five teenagers in Angel Grove. Of course, they're all, like, different. They all have their, like, issues or... They're not exactly, I mean, they're popular, but then, of course, they don't want to be. And you know how it is. They're just, like, kind of almost like outcasts in their own little world. They go into the woods, and they stumble onto these coins. And basically, these coins, having them in their possession, they become super strong. And they can leap, you know, over cliffs or, you know, canyons or whatnot. And they're just... You know how it is, you know, you're trying to use the bathroom and you accidentally break your sink. So they finally go back and go into this spaceship that seems to be, you know, been buried for millions and millions of years. They find this little robot, this little talking robot that's called Alpha, and then this face that comes out of the wall, like I said, looks like one of those pinpoint impression things. I mean, that's what he does, that's exactly what I was thinking about. His name's Zordon, and he tells him about the Power Rangers, and yeah, the coins chose you, so now you guys have to be the Power Rangers to defeat Rita Repulsa, because she wants to destroy the world, because she's looking for a specific coin to just take over the universe. So what did I think of the Power Rangers movie? I enjoyed this a lot more than I thought I was going to. Yeah! I really enjoyed this movie, and you know what really did it for me was the five actors involved. I was really worried when I watched that first trailer. I was like, man, this is going to be cheesy, and they're just going to be bad acting and blah, blah. No, there really wasn't, and everybody keeps on saying it, too, is the kid who plays, I think his name is something, I forgot his name. But the guy who plays the Billy Cranston, the Blue Ranger, he's like becoming a fan favorite because he's just really out there because he's super smart, but he can't, you know, he takes things too seriously and blah, blah, blah. And you almost think like at first, oh my God, is this kid going to be annoying? But you go, no, I really like this kid. But you like them all because they all have their individual traits. They really add to this group. Not to mention the actors all have great chemistry with each other. And you don't really care that they really take a while to establish this origin story, you know, before they're like, you know, let's suit up and start kicking some ass. They really let that boil up. Like they have a whole, it's not just like training montage, boom, they're in the suits, they're in the Zords, and let's kick some ass. It's not like that. I mean, some people draw parallels to Chronicle. Yes, they were already doing that with that first trailer, but I was just kind of surprised on how much I really dug these characters. Like there was moments where they're actually just getting to know each other because they're trying to just figure out how to work with each other. Yeah, and there's also conflict between them too. Not to mention Zordon is like going, he just can't stand it. And speaking of Zordon, Bryan Cranston was great. He was great as Zordon. And even Bill Hader as Alpha, I was worried about. I was not really worried about Bryan Cranston because it's fucking Bryan Cranston. Little worried about Bill Hader, okay? And, you know, everybody's one of those, they say, I won't exactly tell you, but the thing is, when it comes to this movie, they do respect some of the little nuances, some of the little nostalgias within the original Power Rangers movies, but of course, they had to tweak things to make it just make a little more sense at a cinematic level. All except Rita Repulsa. I mean, Elizabeth Banks, I like Elizabeth Banks, and she... I mean, her Rita has like a little bit of a horror element to it. Like, there's like a little scary element to it, which is actually pretty cool. But then, you know, it's a little over the top. It's pretty much, she gets pretty close to the original Rita with like the voice and stuff. A little overdone, but you know what? You just don't care. It's Power Rangers, guys. That's what it is. And when they like suited up and they got in the Zords and they're fighting them off. I mean, the only gripe I had about that, I was like, what does the whole world see? I mean, obviously we live in a world where... You have constant news and communication. Why the fuck are we not like seeing what the whole world is seeing? Like, why is like the National Guard and the Army not showing up while this big gold dude is like trying to destroy Angel Grove? And then all of a sudden you got these Dinobots that are just coming in and trying to defeat it. I guess that's fine because in the original show and the movie and stuff, they didn't really care about that aspect at all. And I guess that's good. But you know what's The great part about this movie is just the chemistry between the Rangers. The five actors did really well. There's some cheesy lines, but there's a lot of good humor in here as well. Like, they're not just trying hard. There's just really, I don't know. I can't emphasize enough how much I really dug these characters. So is Power Rangers going to go on the favorite wall of 2017? You know what? It is. I actually can't wait for the sequel, and I will watch this again and again. Really surprised about this movie. I didn't, like, you know, belly laugh because they weren't going for belly laughs, but I chuckled throughout this movie. I mean, I just really dug the characters, you know, and everything. I like what they did. I like the little subtle changes and the, you know, everything that they had to do. And a lot of people were griping too, like, yeah, this is like just like a Krispy Kreme commercial for, yeah, I get that. There's like a whole emphasis on Krispy Kreme. Like, in like 1 5-minute span, they probably say Krispy Kreme about 67 times. Yeah, I get that. They kind of Michael Bayed that, but it didn't, like, ruin the movie for me. So let me know if you saw Power Rangers down below in the balls area, guys. And what did you think about it? I enjoyed it, man. Please hit that like, thumbs up button if you'd be so kind. Subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to the other channel. And I will see you guys later. Go. Get out of here. Now.